Hello everyone, I'm Lucy Gunawan, the head of the data science practice here at TIMi. Welcome to the third video in our tutorial series about the integration between Anatella and Azure. In the previous video, we got the Azure application ID and the Anatella unlock key, which are required to connect to Azure. Now it's time to put them to use. In this video, I'm excited to walk you through the process of accessing a SharePoint drive. In Microsoft terminology, the SharePoint drive are sometimes referred to as libraries. We'll demonstrate how to perform actions such as listing, downloading, uploading, and deleting files in SharePoint using Anatella. Let's delve into one of the Azure services accessible from Anatella, SharePoint. To clear up any confusion, let's break down the differences between SharePoint files and SharePoint list, something that I initially found quite perplexing myself. A SharePoint site can contain multiple drives and multiple lists. When you create a SharePoint site, it automatically comes with a default drive that is named Document. The Microsoft documentation is somewhat confusing because it refers to these simple drives as libraries. In practice, all common users are using the term drive because that's exactly what they are, a storage for some files and folders. To keep things simple and align with common practice, we'll also use here the term drive in this tutorial. Additionally, the term drive is the one used within Anatella, making it more consistent for our purposes. In a single SharePoint site, you can have multiple drives. Here is an example of a SharePoint drive that contains many folders and files. Now, let's explore lists. Lists are like Excel spreadsheets, but within your SharePoint environment. The advantage of using lists over Excel is that they facilitate teamwork by allowing multiple users to access and update the same datasheets simultaneously. That's a feature not easily achievable with standalone Excel files. Here is an example of a list named My List. Now that we grasped the distinction between drives and lists, let's dive into how you can manipulate both elements within Anatella. In this tutorial, we will focus specifically on working with files in SharePoint. For those intrigued by manipulating lists and list items, which is the row within a list, I invite you to click here to watch the video titled Accessing Azure SharePoint List. So, in this tutorial, you will learn how to use Anatella, 1. To select your SharePoint site and how to select the SharePoint drive that you will access, 2. To retrieve a listing of files from a SharePoint drive, 3. To download files from SharePoint, 4. To upload files to SharePoint, and 5. To delete files from SharePoint. To start, there are two crucial pieces of information you require: the Azure application ID and the Anatella unlock key. The process of obtaining the Azure application ID is covered in the first video of this tutorial series dedicated to the integration between Anatella and Azure. This video titled Anatella First Time Setup to Access App Registration. Click here to view this video. Typically, this first stage is overseen by an administrator. This is a one-time setup for the entire company. The procedure to obtain the Anatella unlock key is covered in the second video of this tutorial about Azure in a video titled Getting Your Personal Anatella Unlock Key. If you need to revisit this second video, you can click here to watch again. Without further ado, let's dive right in. Open inside your browser the SharePoint site that you want to access and take note of the SharePoint site URL address. In this example, here it's TIMi312SharePoint.com site demo 2. Please note that this SharePoint site contains two drives, one drive named Document and another one named My Drive. We'll retrieve the list of files within this document drive. Create a new Anatella file named SharePoint_files.anatella and open it. To begin, search for SharePoint within the Anatella file. Next, drag and drop the SharePoint list option from the drop-down menu into the Anatella canvas. Within the connection parameter section, input the Azure application ID and our Anatella unlock key. Now, navigate to the standard parameter tab and set the operation menu drop-down menu to list file on drive. To choose the SharePoint site you want to access, you have two options. The first option is to click the drop-down menu and select your SharePoint site from the list. This is convenient when we have only a few well-identified SharePoint sites. The second option is to copy and paste the URL of your SharePoint site into the appropriate field. In our example, this URL was timi312.sharepoint.com sites demo 2. The second approach is more convenient when dealing with a large number of SharePoint sites, as it ensures that you easily select the correct one from the many available options. Continuing with the exercise, let's move forward and select our SharePoint drive. Click on the drop-down menu associated with the drive name parameter. We see two drives listed, Documents and My Drive. For this demonstration, let's select the document drive just by clicking on it. Now, let's leave the file filter field and the directory to list field empty for the time being. Under the output type section, choose files and directories and make sure the recursive in subdirectory option is selected to access the content of the entire drive. Let's execute the box. Let's look at the resulting data. We find that the first three rows represent directories as indicated by the isDir value of 1. Conversely, when the isDir value is 0, it indicates a file. Let's illustrate how we can download all the files within a directory and how to download a single file. Let's start by downloading the files from the directory name aa/bb. First, let's list the files inside this directory by typing the desired folder name in the directory to list field. Execute this step. As a result, you'll see that there are three downloadable files within our directory. Next, add the SharePoint file download box. Enter the connection parameters, including the application ID and Anatella unlock key. Within the standard parameters, ensure that the demo site is selected. Execute the process. If you don't specify an output file, the downloaded file will be located inside the same folder as your Anatella file. You can explore this folder to see the downloaded files. To download a single file, let's take the example of downloading the file name my_picture.png from the AA folder and renaming it to my_image.png. For this task, you'll need an inline table with two columns, file path and local file. Input aa/mypicture.png in the file path column and aa/myimage.png in the local file column. Duplicate the SharePoint file download box and set the output file parameter to the local file column. Execute the process. If you see OK in the status, the download was successful. You can verify the downloaded file with which should now be available under the specified name. To demonstrate the process of uploading files to a SharePoint drive, we'll upload a CSV file named demo file to upload.txt that is located here. Let's start by duplicating the previously used inline table. In this duplicated table, write demo file to upload.txt in the local file column. Additionally, rename the file path column to remote file for clarity. Repeat this step with a second row specifying different name. Next, we add to our graph the SharePoint upload box. For the local file to upload parameter, select the local file column. For the file path on SharePoint parameter, select the remote file column. Execute the process. After the completion, verify if the files has been correctly uploaded to the SharePoint site. You should observe that the presence of the two uploaded files on the site. To delete the previously uploaded files, we reuse the existing inline table. Simply duplicate the table and remove the local file column. For the deletion process, we use the same SharePoint upload box. However, this time we choose the mode as delete files on SharePoint. In the property of the box, the file path on SharePoint parameter remains the same. Execute the process. As a result, the two uploaded files are removed from the SharePoint site, confirming the successful deletion. There you have it. In this video, you learn how to manage everything related to files on a SharePoint drive. List the file, download, upload, and delete them. Thank you for joining me in this tutorial. If you have any questions or need further clarification on any of the topics covered today, please feel free to leave a comment below. We highly value your feedback. And if you found this video helpful, don't hesitate to give it a thumbs up. If you're interested in more tutorials, engaging discussions, and useful tips, consider subscribing to our channel. As you might remember from the beginning of this video, we saw that a SharePoint site actually contains two different types of data, drives on one hand and lists on the other hand. Inside this video, we covered everything related to drives, but we didn't cover how to manage the list inside a SharePoint site yet. This will be the topic of the next video. I invite you to click here to access it. See you soon in the next video.